Good morning, children of class 5. Well, today we are going to take up a very special topic in value education today. And this is your first chapter from your book. And the name of the book is Growing Right. Okay? So I hope you all are having this book with you all. And I want to take up this chapter particularly for your first unit examination. That is, It's All Right to Be Angry. Okay? And it is on page number 7. Okay, children? So, let me tell you something about this chapter in a gist manner. And particularly if you say, you can read the line, children, that it's all right to be angry. So, there is, particularly this word, one word you can see over here. There's a one word, angry. So now from this word particularly, you can come to know that this word particularly, that this chapter talks about something related with anger. It's all right to be angry. And you know, when we say about this word particularly, angry, it's an emotion, common human emotion, you can say, children. Okay? So something related with anger management we are going to talk about. And anger management is something, you can say, the way how to deal with this emotion called anger and how to control it. Since you know that it is very harmful for all of us, and it is somewhere it lies as a difficult, complex human behavior, you can say. That's why it needs to be managed in a certain and in a very systematic manner. So let us understand what this chapter tries to tell us. Okay? Anger management is one of the 6 essential life skills. Yes, 6 essential life skills. Life skills are those skills, children, which are like, you know, should know, which can make your life better and which are very essential for your life, related to your life also. Okay? That one needs to learn in order to lead a meaningful and respectful life. Managing anger can improve behavior and also teach how to conduct oneself when angry or confused. Okay? So this chapter particularly talks that suppose if sometimes you feel angry or confused, then how you should react. Because sometimes when we are in the public, or even we are dealing with other people at our home also, so if we know how to control our anger, so particularly there will be times when we can escape ourselves from embarrassing situations, from situations which can lead to out of control sometimes, and you can handle that situation very well, children. Okay, so this chapter you will come to know about how to deal with anger. Okay, anger can be shown in various ways. Okay, anger is shown when hurting someone, disrespecting someone through aggression. Aggression means through when you are exhausting yourself up into something very necessarily. Okay, confrontation of going in a cocoon and sulking, confronting means when you confront your anger, when you show up your anger to someone. Or going in a cocoon or sulking means going in a state of madness, you can say, in a state of confusion complete, in a very sulken state. That means in going into the state of, when things go out of control. Learning to manage this anger helps to understand why one feels angry and what can one do to avoid hurting others. So you have to learn to how to avoid this feeling of anger. Okay, work out how you're feeling, how you're actually feeling angry or just frustrated or disappointed. You must be aware of how you are feeling. Everyone, whenever we are angry, we know that we are feeling angry, children. And that is the way you feel, its anger has no age limit. Any person of any age can feel angry sometimes. And that is a very common and natural phenomena of human emotion. Okay. So are you actually feeling angry or you are just frustrated or disappointment? This line wants to say that sometimes when we are frustrated or disappointment, we feel angry also as well sometimes. But to ensure, we will see how to manage this emotion particularly. You must be aware of how you are feeling. You must also learn to speak up about what you are feeling and why you are feeling. Often, when you are unable to understand your feeling, you act in an aggressive manner. Talk about how you are feeling. Okay? Now coming to this para. Manage your anger. Show that you are angry not by shouting or screaming, but by talking it out. So, the first way of how to manage your anger is not to shout or scream, first of all. Sometimes when we do not like something, we feel angry, we shout. You know, but that is not the way. The way, correct way to show out your anger is to talk it out. Means to bring out what is the, you know, the result, ultimate result or consequence of something. Okay. Talk about why you are angry and what made you upset. So this is a very essential point to know about your anger. It is very important to know the cause of your anger. Why there is a need to feel angry. And why you were upset of something. Then find out the reason, actual reason behind it. Okay, children? Talk about what you feel like doing when angry. Share what you made you angry with the person who made you upset. So this is very important, children, that you have to learn to see that how you have to make yourself angry. Like, why you were angry with the person and why you were upset, you have to find out the real cause, okay? You need to think of ways to cope up with your anger and how to resolve conflicts. You have to learn to cope up with your anger and to resolve means to find out a solution for your problems and for your conflicts. Peacefully, most importantly, try to walk away when you are angry before, you know, before it makes you really mad. So you know you have to get out of the situation when you feel angry before it leads into madness. Okay, so coming to the next point, talking it out will help you manage your anger. Okay, this is very important that you have to talk it out. Make your own anger rules. Okay, your family must have rules about your behavior and is acceptable. Okay, and the line says, what is not, talk to your family and tell them about your anger and how would you want them to behave towards you when you feel so. Okay, when you feel so, just remember that you need to behave respectfully towards others. Being angry does not give you a right to hurt anyone. You cannot show physical aggression, indulge in name calling and break property just because you are angry. So these are things when you are angry you shouldn't do. That is, you should not hurt anyone. Don't say anything which makes others feel hurted. Do not show physical anger. Aggression means physically don't hurt anyone. Indulge in name calling means don't take names of people who in a very wrong manner, in a very bad manner you can say, or break someone's property also. Anything, you don't break of something, anything of any person is because you are angry. Okay, now think up about the consequence. You should always think about the consequence of being angry. Okay, before you react, think of consequences that your reaction will cause. You might not want to face the consequence of things done when in anger. Think why you think that the other person is angry. You have to think also, children, why the other person was angry, feeling angry. Think. What will happen if you call the other person's name just because you were angry and do not know how to manage your anger? Put yourself in other's shoe and then you will understand. And how would you feel if the other person
call your names in anger. In anger, we say, take names of people in a wrong way. You know, we take names in a way when they feel they might get frustrated or angry. Here's what you can do. These are some simple solutions of how to solve your anger. That is, take a deep breath, walk outdoors, start singing aloud. You know, take deep breaths. First of all, you need to take a deep, calm breath. Then you can go out somewhere to change yourself. Start singing some songs that will literally change your mind. Do yoga, something, some physical exercise also you can do. That is, do yoga, martial arts or other forms of any exercise you can do. Okay, punch a pillow, then positive self-talk is there, growl sounds, all these things you can do. Remember, it is all you feel angry, just you need to manage your anger so that you neither hurt yourself or any other person. You cannot hurt yourself. Then you can see how big is your anger. Okay. If your anger is bigger than these, then you need to draw a picture of how big is your anger actually. Use the space below to draw anger bubble and then color the right sized anger bubble in the color that your anger is to blow it away. So these are some boxes given. You have to see if your anger is bigger than this. This is just an activity you can do over here. Okay. Now there is a poem given, children. Learn this poem on anger and start reciting it whenever you feel angry. So whenever you feel angry, you can recite this poem. It says like, when I am angry, here's a rule. I need to take a deep breath until I cool. So you need to, first of all, what does this line means? That you need to take a deep breath and you need until you get cool again whenever you feel angry. Okay, I need to stop and freeze, just calm down practicing ease. I need to put on a smile to remove the frown. So what does this line mean? I need to stop and freeze. You have to stop with that emotion ultimately and just to calm down and put a smile on your face to remove that frown on your, you know, eyebrows. In the eyebrows we frown sometimes, right? We can see when we are angry. So then, so that I don't fight, I'll be happy, I'll be glad I did right, I and don't need to be sad. Stop, calm down and think whatever you do, okay, about what I need to do, I'll feel better. If you need to feel better, then what about to do, I'll feel better. If that's what exactly I'll do, this is what you exactly need to do. So this is all about this poem, children. Learn it by heart. This is your homework, okay?